blogger, a video blogger.
Alexa, pause.
What's going on? Good morning, y'all. Happy Sunday. Just want to pop in here and say good morning. Yeah, it was Sunday. Four more days. I'm 45, yo. Well, by the time you see this, I'm 45. Alexa, play. Can you say a packed freezer? Yo, this shit was hard to do, but I did it. Just finished having lunch, brunch, whatever. My birthday's, well, yeah, I said I wanted, like, I mean, my palm is never messy, but yeah, anyone knows me, I love order. Yeah, those who know I do beading, so I have all my beads all over the table. If you've seen, like, you know, previous vlog, you see the table, all my stuff is on the table. But I'm like, I moved them over to where they supposed to be stored. I was like, so whatever I'm working on, I bring out and then put it back. I'm like, okay, I'm tired of all this shit on my table. I'm tired of it. I mean, I'll keep my butt stuff out. That's nothing. But let me show you. So I'm about to, I just finished eating, so I'm about to clean off the table now. So the table is clear now, about to clean it. And I moved all the stuff. Yeah, so again, whatever I'm working with, I move it, then I put it back. Order. What's up, y'all? Good morning. Happy Monday. It is August 31st. I've been up. I was outside pulling the garbage bin, checking email, work emails on my phone. But I'm up. Now I'm up. I was contemplating on cutting my hair today because I was invited to a focus group tomorrow, and I was like, they filming this. I'm like, I just put some coconut oil and brush this shit down. Well, you know. I'm like, no, I don't feel it. I'm going to cut my hair. My birthday's Friday, so I'm cutting it. Got to cut it Wednesday or Thursday. Yeah. It's nice outside. Nice and cool. I'm like, if it could stay like this. Yeah. Alexa, what's today's temperature?
Right now, it's 68 degrees Fahrenheit. Today, expect a high of 76 degrees.
The fall is my favorite season. I wish the weather could just stay like this all year round. Perfect. Perfecto! Oh, my computer. So I've been rearranging shit in my office. Let me show you. So I put up the tripods. I don't know. I think I said it in the vlog. I put the tripods up. Close with the lights, if they're not being used. And I use this one frequently, and I use that one frequently, so I just left that, blah, blah, blah. Still, I forgot to get the hooks when I was out for to hang those on the wall, so I'm going to do that. But yeah, this is minor shit. Little minor shit. So yeah, so this will be the first time I've ever been a part of a focus group. It's going to be interesting. Yeah, I'm going to take my cameraman if they let me. I'll probably move to film it, but my experience on the way or when I'm in there or whatever. So it's pretty cool. Yeah, I'm like, they was talking about sex and sexuality. Yeah, so I'm like, they want me to be a part of it. Cool, let's talk, because I got a lot to say. So, when I was invited to, I don't know, they must be like, who is this bitch? So I was invited to the focus group, when I got the invitation, the person reached out, would you be interested? And my thing is like, I was like, not to be rude, but who are you? Because anyone know me, I'm very business. I'm very business. I don't have no business. and straightforward. None of this pussyfooting around anything. So I like, you know, so he introduced himself and told me the company's with him, blah, blah, blah. And I, okay, because then he included links to their website and stuff. Yeah, that's the way you, that's how you open up. You know, if someone, you never talked to someone before, you have to put it all out there. So less questions and we get straight to the point. I don't know. To me, that just makes sense. So, you know, my concern with the whole COVID situation was going on. It's going to be filmed in a loft in Brooklyn. I Googled it because I want to know where I'm going. Because I'm in this day and age, I'm not taking anything for like, no. First of all, you a man reaching out to me. I don't know if you're trying to get me someplace to kill me. Look, in this day and age, I ain't playing the shit. Who the fuck are you? I ain't playing. Because I said to myself, if I don't get a logistics by today at 3, I was going to call in with and pull out. Pull out. Yeah, because I'm like, no, I need to know where I'm going. I want to see where the hell the place is, see the area, because y'all not killing me. Shit. It's sad we got to think this way, but it is what it is. So they sent me, you know, you have a whole COVID thing you got to fill out and another questionnaire and a release thing because they're filming it. And as I'm reading it, I see a part, you know, in the release part, it requests your social security number. And I'm like, what the fuck I need to get my social security number for a focus group? The devil? No. So I wrote and I requested. I said, for a focus group, why do I need to provide my social security number? Because the thing is like, for you millennials or people don't know, your social security number, that's not something to play with. Just willy-nilly, just no. That's not something to play. If it's not no financial stuff, I ain't buying no home, I ain't getting no, doing no credit thing. It's not a medical thing. I'm not going to a doctor, you know, the medical. What am I giving you my social security number for? And the thing is this form going into something secure where no one else, because I'm not filling out my social security number and a paper just flying all around everywhere to release. Nah, bitch, I'm not doing it. So I wrote and I asked, you know, why do I need to get my social security number? If they don't respond, whatever, boy, I'm just going to leave that blank. And if it's a problem when I go there, they say, then I just won't do the focus group. I need to know why you need my social security number. Why? This is Wegmans Virgin, wow, version of, this is a store brand version of Fage, how you say that, Fage, whatever, F-A-G-E, Fage, whatever, that's one of my favorite yogurt, but, yeah, so they copy, you know, get it for cheap brand, it's pretty nice, it's not bad at all. So, the gentleman, you know, the organizer for, or the middle, I don't know what I would call him, what part he plays in it, but he's one, you know, that we have to send our content. The company is Snake Nation. I think they're based out of Atlanta, but I guess they travel to do different things. But he just responded to me, said, I'll find out. Because I asked a question about why I got put social security number. Okay, so they responded back and he told me to leave it blank. His boss said, that's like a standard request on these forms. What's up, people? Good morning. 10:08. It is Tuesday, the first day of September. Well, Virgo season started, but I'm just saying, yeah. We are officially in September. I'm hit the shower at 12. This focus group, they say you gotta be there, you know, before 2 because you gotta look for parking and like, you know, yada, 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 yada. What's this? So, yeah, hit the shower at 12. Take my time. Cause, yeah, I don't like to rush and stuff. I'm not, take my time, get ready. Leave it right between 1 and 1:15. Yeah, because I, you know, Google the area, so I know. But yeah, parking over there is maybe a little trying, but we gonna see. I'm gonna use my phone camera. I'm not gonna take the camera there just in case, you know. Oh, no filming. So I mean, with a phone, you can't, you know. I could be inconspicuous.
Anyone east of the street for half a mile.
I just left the house. I'm supposed to be there for 2 o'clock. It's 1:21. I was doing some unexpected stuff. I came out, put the no parking signs back on the garage. When my dad finished doing. He was varnishing the garage, so I put the signs up, and I was messing with the garbage, and I was like, ooh, gotta go. Dope experience. Unfortunately, this is not something that's going to be available on YouTube. It's for the company's personal use and their, you know, presentation for, well, it's a presentation that they're presenting. But I would say it's in the medical, something in the medical field. It's pretty dope. I mean, I really enjoyed this. My first time being part of a focus group. You know, it's cool meeting different people and hearing different experiences and sharing different experiences. It's pretty dope. So, I'm ready to go home. They fed us that food. I didn't want to eat there. I just took it with me. So, let's get on the road. I'm wondering why all this damn traffic. They're doing construction here. Shut up. And now this fucking car, he see me want to come over and he want to edge up. Nigga, you letting me in. What's up, y'all? Let's go to Michael's. Michael's, well, not in and out. It's funny how I come when they're having sales. I was like, bless the Lord. So I'm excited about what I got to create and stuff like that. I gotta download the app on my phone because, like, you spend so much and you get something in rewards, but I have to add the app on my phone, so I need to download that. But yeah, so I'm about to head back home. I have an all staff meeting in an hour, virtually. So, yeah, let's get back on the road.